peacemaker, servant of God, helper, comforter, encourager, woman of faith, were some of the things Cathy Schoeman was known for. Many lives were affected and changed because of her faithfulness and her walk with the Lord. On June 12, 1992, she went to be with Jesus. She left precious memories as well as a big emptiness. It took us a long time to get over. It was a privilege to have had a mother like her. I thank God for the legacy of Cathy Schoeman, my mom. For the Lord is She's 17 in Junie. 5 days nadat mama hemel toe is. Ek is hier in haar slaapkamer. Ons gaan haar vandag ter ruste lê, haar liggaam. Ek is hier in haar slaapkamer. Wys net so 'n paar van die pragtige blomme. Ons het soveel pragtige woorde gehad, aanmoediging, dierbare vriende wat ons het, woorde sal nooit kan sê wat dit vir ons beteken nie. Toe die musiek is wat mama vir ons gebring het vir Edma. Ons speel dit baie en ons is baie lief voor. En toe mama nou weg is, toe bring Edma die tapie terug. Die lied wat nou daar speel, Let's Take Time to Worship the Lord. Die bosie daar is van Pastor Ray en Lindy. Met pragtige woorde daarby. Hierdie blommetjies kom van oom Nick. Ag, oom Manny. En tannie Molly van Zanien. Die mooi kaartjies. Ons het natuurlik vir die mense gevra om liewer on hands of compassion iets te gee. Hier vrijdagmiddag, so uur voor mama weg is, het ek die eerlijke tydjie met haar gehad, in die hand vastgehou, met haar gepraat. Ek het nog vir Anton gebel net voor dit, en haar kom sê dat Anton sê liefde, toe druk sy my hand so, en sy het geregistreer en baie waardeer, toe ek sê Anton sê liefde. In haar waterbeker. Kita, julle sal hierdie onthou.
Suffering, my love and my perseverance. And I hope that I can say that at the end of my life, that I've set an example that is worthy to follow. That's the question that we should ask ourselves. When I'm gone, will the witness that I left behind still carry on? And thank God for that example that she set. And I want to say this, death does not cancel her prayers. The power of her prayers is still continuing. Death cannot destroy her love, because the power of that love is still working in our lives. So death is not the end. You know, here in verse 12 of chapter 1, Paul talks about, he says, I know whom I have believed and am persuaded that he is able to keep what I have committed to him until that day. I know in prayer she has committed many of us to the Lord. And I know that she prayed with great faith that God is able to keep us until that day. And the power of that prayer is still continuing. Pastor Ray McCauley has shared how she many times shared with him how she prayed for him. Even before his ministry was started. Even before he arrived back in South Africa to start the ministry. She already prayed for him without knowing him. And the power of that prayer we can still see in operation. You know, it's like the blood that still speaks. And there are so many things that are still speaking. Though she might have gone to be with the Lord, we can still hear those things. A next example of the inheritance that she's left us is the teaching and the doctrine. And this is what Paul says. Listen to verse 13 here. He says, "Hold fast the pattern of sound words which you have heard from me in faith and love which are in Christ Jesus. That good thing which was committed to you, keep by the Holy Spirit who dwells in us." You could never go to the home of the Schumanns and not come out of there being blessed by spiritual words that were spoken of. And we treasure those words and we hold fast to them. Henny just shared with me how just 2 weeks before her death, she led the last person to the Lord. When somebody came and had to work on something in the house, and the woman was led to the Lord and walked into the room where Henny was lying on the bed and said to him with tears in her eyes, "Auntie Cathy just led me to the Lord." What an example. And then, let me say this, her faith will continue. You know, it's amazing here when Paul says, "I call to remembrance the genuine faith that is in you, which dwelt first in your grandmother and in your mother, and I am persuaded is in you also." We can leave a legacy of faith to our children. What God gave to us and deposited in us, we can transfer and we can leave that inheritance. And I want to say to Arthur and Henny, what an inheritance of genuine faith that was in your grandmother. What a precious inheritance. And then lastly, let me say this. She left an inheritance of precious works. And I want to read this scripture from Revelation chapter 14. Because this is so beautiful. In Revelation chapter 14, and in verse 13, it says this about those who die in the Lord. It says, "Then I heard a voice from heaven saying to me, 'Write, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on.'" Now, if they're blessed, that means it's not the end. Amen? It says, "Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on. Yes, says the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors and their works follow." Their works follow them. Her works follow. It was our privilege many times to be guests in the home of the Schumanns.
Het 'n rusplek geword vir so baie mense. En dit sal nog 'n rusplek wees wat vrede bring vir so baie mense. En haar werke was nie vir nie. I thank God that the Bible says in 1 Corinthians 15 and verse 58 that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. We were left with such a rich inheritance. But let me just go on to something else and say, not only have we been left with an inheritance, not only do we have so many things to remember her by, but Sister Cathy has also received such a rich inheritance. And death is not the end of them. death is just a continuation of the blessings of the Lord. Here in 1 Corinthians 15, it says in verse 51, "Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible has put on incorruption, and this mortal has put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your sting? O Hades, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain." Where Sister Kathy is right now, she's experiencing the ultimate beauty. This is what it means. Death is not the end. We must all be changed. This corruptible must put on incorruption. And this is just a change for her. This is the transition. And as you have noticed on the sheet here, this is a graduation service. Because she has just graduated to her final destiny. She has just been transferred and transported to her eternal home. This is what she lived for. She is experiencing the ultimate right now because she has seen Jesus face to face. And she has moved to heaven, a real place, a better country. And it's not the end. Now I'm sure she's having a feast. I'm sure she's watching from the pavilions of heaven and rejoicing to that. Then the next part of her inheritance is she has the hope of resurrection. In verses 51 and 52, it says here, "We shall not all sleep." You see, when the Bible speaks of the death of the righteous, it doesn't even call it death. It says we are sleeping because it's not permanent. Because there's going to be a day of awakening. There's going to be a day of resurrection where the dead in Christ will be raised incorruptible. Because we already have received eternal life. But you know what? It's much more than just resurrection. It's much, much more than just being raised from the dead. But the Bible speaks of immortality, which means we We will be raised incorruptible. Hallelujah. Death has no sting. Hades has no victory. Because we have the victory in Jesus. And where she is now, there's no sickness. There's no pain. There's no suffering. And no affliction. That's victory. What a great inheritance. She is in the presence of Jesus for a sake. The day that she lived for her whole life has arrived. She's looking into his face and experiencing the reality of the presence of God. So there's a rich inheritance that has been left, both for us, but not only left for us, but that our sister has received. There's this blessed hope of reunion that we have. That we will see each other again. Let me conclude this word by just leaving two questions with you. And I think it's so important for us to ask ourselves these questions. What inheritance, what legacy will you leave behind? What example will there be? Will there be a faith to God? Will your works still continue? Will they follow you? That's question that we need to ask ourselves. What legacy will I leave behind? And then the second question is, what inheritance will I receive when I die? And I really believe that we have the opportunity right now to make sure that there will be a blessed reunion. And if in your heart you are not sure that you will make heaven one day, you are not sure that if you had to die, that heaven will be your eternal home, you can have that assurance today. And I believe it will be the most joyful thing for Sister Kathy that if somebody here who did not have the assurance of salvation, who did not have that sure knowing in their heart that if they were to die, that heaven will be their eternal destiny. If somebody can have that assurance and leave with that assurance in this from this service today, that would be the thing that would bring the most joy to her heart, and I know to the family's heart today. So I want us to just bow our heads and close our eyes. Just anybody else? Anybody else? God bless you. Thank you. You can put your hand down again. Thank you, sir. God bless you. I know there's rejoicing in here right now. If there's anybody else that want to be included in this prayer, I want you to raise your hand as a token before God that you want to receive eternal life in Jesus. Anybody else? Then we're going to pray. Let's all stand. And if you raised your hand, I'm going to pray a special life in Jesus Christ. Thank you that through His appearance, death has been abolished. The sting of death has been removed. Oh, death, where is your sting? Oh, Hades, where is your victory? We thank you, Father, that when sin is removed from our lives, that sting of death is removed. We know that it might hurt, but it's not the end. We know that it might be a sorrowful thing for the family in the sense that it's a goodbye, but we know that it's just a graduation to our eternal home and our eternal destiny. Father, right now I pray on behalf of those people that have raised their hands, indicating that they want to make sure that they will spend eternity with you. I thank you right now that we can confess that as sinners we need a Savior. We cannot save ourselves. We cannot obtain eternal life out of our own efforts. But we thank you that right now we receive Jesus Christ. And with Jesus Christ, inviting Him into our hearts, we also receive the gift of eternal life. And we thank you that we can now call ourselves children of God, knowing that we have eternal life and that we will live forever. And that physical death will not be the end, but it will just be our graduation to be with Jesus forever. Father, I thank you right now that there is rejoicing in heaven. I thank you that as Sister Kathy watches from the pavilions of heaven, that she's rejoicing with us because of these people that have entered into the kingdom of life. Thank you, Father, that in dying we can receive life. And we thank you that it's eternal, it will never cease. We thank you for that in Jesus' name. Amen.
Ons graag net 'n paar bedankings maak. Eerstens aan almal wat hier teenwoordig is, die wat naby gekom het, die wat van ver af gekom het, ons waardeer julle teenwoordigheid. Die kaartjies, die telefoonoproepe, die woorde van bemoediging is vir ons kosbaar. En namens papa, vroukie en oumaakie, ons allemaal waardeer het baie. Dubs en Wilmot, wil ons toch net dankie sê vir die reëlings en verkeersafdeling. Celia en Mercia, for your contribution. We really appreciate it. It was such a blessing. Pastor Mark en Cora Hodgetts en Dean Vic en Carol Mundy, you guys are special. I want to thank you for the support and your assistance, especially on the night just after Mommy went to be with Jesus. We so appreciate that. You'll never know how much it meant to us as a family. My very good friend, Pastor Mark Hodges, for conducting this service, for those beautiful words. We appreciate you, Mark. You're a blessing. And I trust and I know you'll continue to be just that. Carol and Copy for playing for us. We appreciate the music. Mom so much appreciated that through the years, and you guys have blessed her. No end. The same breath, Brian Gibson, for his blessing, and we'll hear him later this afternoon. Brian, so many times he just popped in at home and he would just play and sing to Mom and Dad. And on Sunday afternoon he came by and just shared with us beautiful words of encouragement and those songs. Brian, you're a blessing, a real instrument of God. Continue in your good work. Members of the Rhema band, I know that for Mom it was always a highlight every year that we got together. Many of us, not the whole band, but many groups of the band got together more often than once. And I know she'd prepare for weeks and months just to be ready to receive the bunch of the Rhema band. It was like her kids, and they were all like children in her home. And we just want you to know that it's still your home. Nothing's changed. You're still welcome there. My dad's still there, and we appreciate you all. Tabisa and Rosie. Vir julle hulp oor die laaste 20 jaar wil ons vir julle baie dankie sê. En Rosie speciaal, die laaste paar dae wat jy die missie so mooi opgepas het, ontwaardeer het. Sy het vir mama opgepas, sy het omtrent alles vir mama gedoen. My papie is nie gezond self nie, en ons waardeer wat sy vir haar gedoen het. En my vroukie Edma, wat mama sy hand altyd hoog gehou het, haar lewe ingekleer het, deur vir haar blomme te gee terwyl sy gelewe het. Enige moeilike daad het Edma met mama gedeel en haar las help lig te maak. Ons waardeer het my skat, baie dankie. Sharon en Skalk, vir julle bydra met die grafbrief en ook julle bystand, ons waardeer het baie. Dan laastens aan papa, vir sy liefde, bystand, recht door die einde toe. Sy ondersteuning van 41 jaar lang is 'n ware voorbeeld van onselfsugtige Christelike toewyding. Ons sê dankie pa, namens die kinders, ouma, al die familie. And not the least, we want to thank God for giving us a mother who was real, who gave meaning to the word mother. She gave of herself until there was no more to give. She loved without expecting anything in return. She lived for others until her very life on earth ran out. Where she is now, she can keep on doing what she loved best. Forever. Ons sal haar mis, maar die wonderlike herinneringe sal by ons bly tot ons haar weer sien. Ons sê dankie Here vir mama Kath. Baie dankie mama.
up the names of the pallbearers that will officiate at the church. And let me also just read out the names, first of all, of those pallbearers that will officiate at the graveside. They will be Billy Wilson, brother, Havel Schoeman, grandson, Penny Schoeman, junior, grandson, Johan van Heerden, nephew, Poppet van Heerden, nephew, and Aaron Wilson, nephew. I'm going to ask the pallbearers that are officiating at the church to please come forward and just take their place.
Before your throne to worship, Lord, you are. Lord, you
want to thank God for giving us a mother who was real, who gave meaning to the word mother. She gave of herself until there was no more to give. She loved without expecting anything in return. She lived for others until her life on earth ran out. Where she is now, she can keep on doing what she loves best forever. We'll miss her, but the wonderful memories will remain until we meet again one day. We say thank you, Lord, for Mama Kath, my mom.
Hallelujah.